Hey guys, my name's Ina and welcome back to my channel. So today we are doing a makeup tutorial on the look that I have on my face right now. It's just this golden, sultry, smoky eye that I actually wore on a recent video that I uploaded here in my channel. I will put a link in the description box below, and a lot of you actually liked that look. So if you want to see how I do it, just keep on watching. Mwah. First, I'm priming my lips and I'm using my EOS Lip Balm in Summer Fruit. And then I'm taking my e.l.f. eyelid primer in the shade Sheer, and I'm just priming my eyelid with this one and blending that out using my fingertips. Now I'm taking my BH Cosmetics It's Judy Time palette, and I'm taking the lightest shade on a fluffy blending brush, and I'm just setting the eyelid primer with this shade. This will really help us blend out all the other eyeshadows that we will put on top of it. And then I'm taking this light brown shade from the same palette, and we are using this as our transition shade, just blending as I go. After blending everything out, we're taking our NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in the shade Bronze, and I'm using this as my base for the next eyeshadow that we will put on top of this. Now, since we have some harsh lines, I'm just using the same blending brush that we used a while ago and canceling out all the harsh lines. And since a lot of the product was actually faded away by the blending, we're just going to reapply the same Bronze Jumbo Eye Pencil. Taking this gold shade from the same palette, which, as you can see, I have abused, I'm taking that on the inner part of my eyelid. And flipping the brush on the other side, I'm taking this copper shade and applying that on the outer corners of my eyes. Again, flipping the brush and just making sure that these two colors blend together. Now taking this deep purple shade, which almost looks black actually, I'm just putting that on the outer corners of my eyes. And since I have hooded eyelids, I'm making sure that I also apply it on the middle part of my eyes, since that will really help open up my eyes and make it look bigger. Just using the tip of the brush, I'm applying the same color on my crease, and then tilting the brush on the side to help blend everything together, or so that we don't have any harsh lines. Taking these two colors from the palette, and this will really help us with our transition so that everything looks really blended well. Just reapply the purple shade, since a lot of that got faded away due to the blending. And same goes for the gold shade. Taking this royal blue shade from the same palette, I'm taking that on a smudger brush and I'm just applying that on my lower lash line. And taking the lightest shade from the palette, I'm using this for my inner corner highlight and for my brow highlight as well. Alright, now let's move on to the brows. I'm just using a spoolie to brush my brow hairs in place, and I'm using my Sansan brow pencil in the shade number 2 to outline my brows first, and then brushing them in with an eyebrow brush just to help them make look more natural. Thank you. now it's time for falsies, and I'm just using this pair that I got from the Changge for only 15 pesos, yes, 1-5, and just applying that on my upper lash line, of course. Memories die out too hard. We were traveling the mountain. Now that we have that on, I'm moving on to mascara, and I'm using my L'Oreal Voluminous Miss Manga mascara, and I'm just applying that on my lower lashes just to balance out the whole look. Alright, now let's move on to the face. I'm using my Maybelline Baby Skin Pore Eraser, and I'm just focusing this on the center of my face and then blending that out using my fingertips. For foundation, I'm mixing the Essence Day All Day foundation and the Sans Sans Soleil matte foundation. I'm just mixing this concoction on the back of my hand and dotting that all over my face and blending that out using my Beauty Cosmetics buffing brush. Forgot to line my eyes beforehand, so I'm just using this Sans Sans Kohl eyeliner to tight line my upper lash line, and I'm trying to build up the product on the inner part of my eyes where we don't have any of the false lash, if you know what I mean. Now time for concealer. I'm using my Essence Day Natural Concealer, and I'm just canceling out all the darkness under my eyes, and I'm using this concealer to highlight the center part of my face. Blended out the concealer on my under eye area using my fingers. I like to follow up using a buffing brush just to make sure that there are no harsh lines and that everything looks seamless. Now to set all the hard work that we have done, I'm taking my e.l.f. mattifying powder in the shade Corrective, and I'm just applying that on my basically everywhere. Now to bronze up my face, I'm using my e.l.f. blush and bronzer duo in Turks and Caicos. I don't know if I said that right, but I really love the bronzer of this duo, as in it looks super nice. It looks kind of cool, but a little bit warm as well. It's not super warm as what the other bronzers look like, so you can really contour your face with this one. It's just like a middle ground brown color, and I love it. For blush, I'm just using the blush that comes in the duo, and I also really love the blush that comes with this duo. It's like a dusty rose kind of color, and it has a bit of shimmer in it, so I don't have to apply any highlight anymore. And now taking my Sans Sans single eyeshadow in the shade Deep Earth Brown, my trusty Sans Sans Deep Earth Brown, to contour my nose. And for lip liner, I'm using the Nichido lip liner in the shade Rosette. And I'm trying to make my lips look a bit more pouty just on the middle part of my lips so that we don't look like a duck. And after that, I'm going over the whole thing using my Too Faced Melted Lipstick in the shade Melted Peony. That wasn't really the shade that I was going for. I'm actually going over the whole thing again using my lip liner just to help blend everything together and to get the shade that I wanted. And basically, that's the whole look. I hope you enjoyed watching and I hope this was helpful for everyone. And if you did find it helpful, don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to see more videos. And comment down below if you have any video requests or any questions for me. And I hope to see you in the next one. Bye! Mwah.